Now we would request our principal sir from Nagarjuna College, Dr. S. G. Gopal Krishna, to address the gathering.
My humble pranams to Sri Swami, respected audience from Sri Sathya Sai institutions, Sri Sathya Sai Annapurna Trust, volunteers, faculty members from our college and students. Our college is the first college which has introduced such a rural development program. 70% of the Indian population lives in the rural area. We have seen how Swami has done wonders in all parts of the rural India. Keeping that in mind, we thought we should not put our students only into the classroom environment. They should go outside the classroom and learn something. How do they do that? It's very difficult to take them to any village or structurally plan a course, because we are an autonomous college. We have given credit also to that. When we give credit, it should be systematic. The planning of the syllabus, curriculum design, delivery, and assessment, all these need to be done very systematically. It was at that time that we got an opportunity to meet Sri Sampath, Mr. Anand, and Sai Prasad, Girish, Surya Narayan, who has come here, all of them. It was an opportunity for me to interact with them and learn about the Annapurna Trust, the activities of Annapurna Trust. I was totally amazed. See, at that time when they came and met me, it is about 6 months back, they told me that they are feeding about 30,000 children at that time. And today I learned that they have touched 85,000 students. Fantastic improvement. It is all because of the blessings of Swami. As an individual, as a human being, it is impossible to do this. See, I attended one of the meetings of the Annapurna Trust, where they mentioned they have presented papers in Stanford and Harvard. I am very lucky that after introducing this course in our college, I have been invited this week. Tomorrow I am going to Delhi to present about the IRD program that we have taken up in front of all the MPs of this country. It is all again the blessings of Swami. As an individual human being, it is very difficult to do all this. Our students also, I inquired with them that they have enjoyed this entire activity. One of the example is, some students, they observed, Girish was mentioning some of the issues that they have highlighted. One of the student batches told us that these school children did not have plates to eat the meals. Midday meal, they did not have the plates. So our students thought that as a group, let us donate some steel plates to the school. This is the kind of transformation See, they are all young, 16, 18 years age boys and girls, and if this kind of thought comes to their mind, what else we require? This is the kind of transformation I was looking, and it is all the blessings of Swamiji. It is because of that all these are happening. One or two points about our management. Sri J.V. Rangaraju is the chairman of the college. He is the director of the Nagarjuna Construction Company in Karnataka. Sri Devi Rangaraju is his better half, and she is the founder member of our all our schools and colleges. Her father, Dr. A.V.S. Raju, he is the chairman of Nagarjuna Construction Company, a strong devotee of Sathya Sai Baba. He has written 46 volumes of books, 46 volumes of books, a chairman of a company which is almost the second largest construction company in the country, the chairman, they don't find time. But he has made himself the time and he has written 46 volumes. In fact, one set he has sent to our college to give it to the Muddenahalli Trust here, and we have donated those books to the Sathya Sai institutions here. The interesting part is, when Sathya Sai Baba left this earth, after that our chairman stopped writing. This is something unbelievable. He was writing when Sai Baba was there, and that means there is some external force which was coming to his mind, and it is because of that he was able to write all those poems. He has stopped after that. Now he does not write poems at all. See, there is some kind of unseen influence on human beings which it should be experienced. It cannot be expressed, it cannot be explained, but it should be experienced. I had a request with Swami that you should bless all the 600 students of this integrated rural development program. Therefore, I requested for a visit here to Sathya Sai institutions, and they have all helped us out, and Swami readily agreed and said, you bring them here. This is the blessing that we wanted. All our children should be blessed, Swamiji. All our children should be blessed, and all our children should flourish in their life, in their professional life. They should be successful with all their wish, whatever wish they have. Keeping that in mind, I wanted an interaction like this. This was the first wish. I have another wish, Swami. Please, only 600 students of the second year have come here. There are other 3 years of students there. 1,800 students are there. 600 have come here. So those 1,800 also needs the blessing of you. And I request you to come to our institution once. Please. Anyhow, I make a request and with the Swami about the integrated rural development program again. See, it is all, I think, Swami's blessings that has come to my mind, that we should have something like this, and we have gone ahead with the structure, we have taken the approval, everything, and our students are today blessed, and they are going ahead. I have a request with the students that, see, we had a lot of interactions like this in the auditorium before we started this program, and I had told you to take this work seriously. You have to take this integrated rural development activity seriously and try to help the rural children, rural people, be it in teaching the computer science, be it in teaching mathematics, be it in teaching English, it can be anything, whatever. It can be even teaching a dance, teaching a music to the children, school children, help them out. Whatever talent you have, please share that. Knowledge will enhance when it is shared. So therefore, I have a request with the students, please share your knowledge, try to help in whatever way that is possible. I had an interaction with Dr. Raghupati also in one of the occasions, and on behalf of all these 600 students, I feel that we should be the volunteers for the medical camps that you are organizing. It's a wonderful activity that Swami is taking up. They are coming up with a hospital also, I learned here, and we are with the Sathya Sai group of institutions, and our students will be definitely turned towards the helping the society with these few words. Thank you very much for the opportunity provided to me, and again, my pranams to Sri Sathya Sai Baba Swami.